Hi everyone, welcome to my new video. In this video, we're talking about the silk of India. In previous video, we're talking about the why is sericulture, what is sericulture, okay? In this video, silk of India, okay? Silk is the culture of the Indian, okay? There are varieties of silk production take place here. That is dress materials, scarf, stole, silk sari is unique here, right now? And this silk is a very important, okay, in the India, okay. Then these silks are the weaver, not only the weaver with yarn, but with intense feeling and emotion. In India, there are number of silk weaving center spread all over the country, known for their distinct and typical style and products, right? Then for Indian, particularly ladies, silk is a lifeline. Okay, no two sarees can be same design left to the choice of weaver. Thus, there is an innumerable pattern or diversity. It means number of patterns and number of diversity present here in silk sarees or the number of material. Right now, then some of the famous silk center in India are the Andhra, Assam, Bihar, Gujarat, Jammu and Kashmir, Karnataka, Chandigarh, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. Right now, there are number of center present here, okay? And after the center, here the distribution of silk industry in India. About 80% of the silk produced in countries of the mulberry silk. Right now, you know that there are number of type of the silk present here, number of type of the insect feed on the different type of the plants. Right now, but the 80% of the silk production in the country is about is of the mulberry silk, majority of which is produced in the three southern states of Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. It means number of large number of production take place first in three states of Karnataka, that is Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, okay, followed by the West Bengal and Jammu Kashmir. Mulberry sericulture is practiced since time immemorial in the northeastern region. Okay, and the tropical tassar silk is produced largely in the central India, covering the tribal areas of Jharkhand, Chandigarh, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and Orissa. And the oak tassar is produced in Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, Uttarakhand, Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, it means this mulberry silk, then after the mulberry silk, tassar silk, oak tassar, okay, this type of the silk production take place here, but out of that large number of production of the mulberry silk take place here. Then iri is grown in Assam and the adjacent northern eastern state Bihar, West Bengal and Odisha. Okay, these are the distribution of the Indian silk. Then history. Sericulture is a labor intensive, rural agro-based, export-oriented cottage industry. Right now, the Chinese tale of the discovery of the silkworm silk was by an ancient empress, Li Zhu, the wife of the emperor. She was drinking tea under the tree, under this mulberry tree, when a silk cocoon fell into her tea cup and the hot tea loosened the long strand of silk. What happened here? As she it out and started to wrap the silk thread around her finger, she felt the warm sensation. When silk run out and larva appear, she realized it was the larva that produces the silk. Soon she taught this to people and become widespread. This is the basic history of this silk. Okay, here Chinese impress, then what happened here in this tea, what happened here, fell the cocoon, then silkworm cocoon fell into the hot tea, then silk strand unravel and larva expose here. Okay, this is the history of the silk. Then government of India has established Central Silk Board in 1949 for the planned development and progress of sericulture. And this all information also present in this Central Silk Board website also, okay, because this all information are we take up from the this website. Government of India has established silk producing center at Assam, Bengal, Mysore, Karnataka, Jammu Kashmir. Right now, it means this government of India firstly established central silk board in 1949, then established silk producing center in Assam, Bengal, Mysore, Karnataka and Jammu Kashmir. China is ranking first in the world in the production of silk. Right now, after the China, then the India is a second ranking position in the world for production of the silk. Okay, these are the important species of the silk moth, that is mulberry silk, tropical tassar silk, temperate tassar silk, muga silk and the eri or erandi silk. Okay, and the species of this silk, mulberry silk species is the Bombyx mori, tassar silk that is tropical tassar silk species is the Anthria miltia, temperate tassar silk species is the A. proeli and A. royali, muga silk is the A. asma. And Erandi silk is the Philosamia ricini. Okay, and there are number of host plant present here. Okay, it means mulberry silkworm also have the different type of the host plant, that is Morus alba, Morus indica, Morus serrata, Morus latifolia. Then tassar silks have the Terminalia domesticia. Okay, Terminalia arjuna. Then temperate tassar silks have the oak plant present here. Muga silks have the soam plant present here, and then the Erandi silk or Eri silk has the Erandi plant present here, the castor plant present here, and they are distributed in the different places. Means mulberry silk distributed in Europe, China and USA, tropical tassar silk distributed in tropical forest zone ranging from Bihar, Jharkhand to Karnataka, temperate tassar silk is distributed in sub Himalaya region and eastern India, muga silk distributed in Brahmaputra Valley, and the Eri silk distributed in Assam, eastern part of the India. Okay, these are the Indian trends present here. Okay, it means 83% of the multi-holatine mulberry production take place. Okay, what is mean by the multi-holatine, bi-holatine, uni-holatine, we can see in next video. Okay, but 83% of the multi-holatine mulberry production take place. Then 6% bi-holatine mulberry production take place, 1% muga, 8% eri and 2% tassar silk production take place in Indian trends in 1890. Okay, and these are the references used during the preparation of this PPT. Okay, and these all the information present in the Central Silk Board website. Okay, thank you very much.